Hey everyone, and welcome into another edition of Team Check-In. Today, I'm joined by three of the members of the Tartarus Titans. We got Cyclone, Spin, Aurora, and Paul joining us. Guys, thanks so much for coming in and talking with us. Only three of you right now, but you know, we're doing the best we can. What's the deal? Where's Scary and Benji? They just didn't feel like coming today?
Yeah, Scary's decided he's driving a different day, and then Benji's sick. He has food poisoning.
Oh, well, F in the chat. Hopefully he's feeling better. Ronnie, whatever, man. He's just going to do whatever he's doing. I'm excited to watch your guys' team play because I think that there's this really weird mix of high expectations. I mean, obviously, you guys have so much talent across the board, a huge pedigree of championships for your team, but also an interesting mix of play styles that I think from the outside looking in, there's a lot of question marks on how you guys are going to mesh. Aurora, we can start with you. Did you have that concern coming in with this team that the play styles might not mesh well together at the beginning?
Yeah, maybe not at the beginning, but I feel like that's every team you join. Like, things definitely take a while to get used to going. And then the other thing is that Scary's moving into the jungle. So
right.
I think it'll be really interesting to see how it works out. I think it's going to work out really well.
Yeah, he's looked good so far on rank streams, at the very least. You know, I've been impressed with what I've seen. Paul, I mean, you're going to be working with him a lot. You were teammates with Scary over the last few years. How do you think he's going to work with you in that jungle role?
I don't know. I think it's going to be pretty good. I mean, I've teamed with him for like my entire SPL career, right? So I think it's going to go pretty well. I mean, I guess time will tell, though.
Yeah.
And tell him the story about how you just like Scary jungle, and I was like, okay.
Oh yeah. So
it was his idea.
During the free agency, basically our team imploded. So then it's just like me and Ronnie are just like in like the middle of nowhere, and like all the other teams are kind of like formed already. And then I think, I don't know, I was talking with Aurora or whatever, and then he's like, we need a jungler, and he's like, I'm just like, what about Ronnie Jungle, dude? He can jungle, right? Because I played ranked with him. We duo queued a bit. He would jungle. I'd mid back in season 7 and season 6. So
yeah, they already got the synergy.
That's it.
Oh, well, if it was getting MMR, then what's like the worst that could
true.
Happen?
True. I mean, if we can gain MMR, we can win Worlds, right?
Exactly. Worked the last 2 times.
True.
Yeah, it seems like that's been working for you so far, Paul. You're getting that MMR. But Paul, I got a bone to pick, man. You're hitting the early queues and you're slamming stuff like set mid. No one in the early queues is gonna be able to handle that, man.
I'll play in any queue, man. I just want to play set mid.
Fair enough. Well, I don't think anyone really wants to play against it at any point, to be fair. I think that from my perspective, one of the things that I'm excited to see what you guys do is obviously what Scary's gonna do. But Paul, between you and Cyclone, I mean, both of you guys have been so team-defining in the way that you want a team fight. Cyclone, how do you think that you're going to mesh with Paul's play style coming into this year? Do you think you're going to have to make major adjustments, or do you think that you can make it work?
I think we'll just have to adjust with time. Obviously, we've never played with each other, so we won't actually, you know, mesh completely, but over time, one of us will just adjust the other, and we'll just be fine.
Have you guys started scrimming quite yet?
You've been little bit, but
sparingly.
Bad ping, bad PCs, all that jazz in the off season. So
right.
So it's like scrims, but I feel like we're gonna start ramping up now. So we'll see what happens in scrims then.
What one of the things that I was curious about is that, you know, Aurora, you're always thought of as one of the premier leaders in the SPL, but we talk about communication in the mid 3v3 a lot. Paul, from, you know, that's, you're usually the guy who's a little bit more focused, at least from what I've heard, that you're not usually one of the more communicative people. Scary, sort of the same thing. Is that something that you're concerned about at all, Aurora, that maybe burdening a little bit more of the communications load on this squad?
I'll just have to see. I haven't played enough games to really get a feel for how it's going to go yet. And then I also feel like communication is always just different in terms of like in terms of the speed of the game too. Like SPL games tend to be a little bit slower, so we'll see how it goes in SPL games and stuff like that. But scrim so far, it's been pretty good. So we just got to keep working on it and getting better as a team.
Yeah, we were just talking about basketball before we turned on the cameras, and I kind of think of you guys as like the Nets right now, where you've got all these great players. You know, you've got your KD, your Kyrie, your James Harden, but there's only one ball to go around. You know, who's going to get the ball on any given night? Do you feel like that sort of style, you know, historically, like Paul for you guys on SK, and then PK, it was we're going to play through mid, we're going to facilitate Paul through team fights. Cyclone, for a lot of your career, it's been facilitating you and getting you in that comfortable spot. Do you think that it's possible to be a team where we're not always facilitating our mid laner, we're not always facilitating our ADC, but a little bit more draft dependent or matchup dependent? Do you think that adjusting that style is going to be difficult for you guys at all?
I don't know. I don't think so. I think it's just going to come with time like any other team. I feel like just playing games and just trying to figure out what works for us and what doesn't and how we want to do things. Like it could be in any lane, anywhere. We just need time and we need to figure out like how things are going to work out. And I think we'll be really good. So I'm not worried about it at all.
Yeah. Aurora, for you and Cyclone, I mean, last year you guys didn't have the best of regular seasons on Radiance, but ended up performing really, really well at every playoff event. I mean, you finished second at Phase 1 and Phase 2 playoffs, and then made it to the semifinals, of course, at Worlds, and we're very close to eliminating PK. Do you feel like your years last year were undervalued, that you didn't get as much recognition as you might have deserved, or do you think that you do consider it kind of a down year for you guys?
No, for me, I don't know if for Cyclone, I feel like it's different for us, but for me, I felt like I didn't have the greatest year last year. It was probably one of my worst years, like out of all the SPL seasons. But like you said, like in playoffs, I do feel like I played really well. And at Worlds, I felt like I had some pretty strong games as well. I didn't feel weak in any of the games. But during the regular season, yeah, for sure, it was definitely not my best year. But one of the things which made it hard last year is that I feel like our team didn't really have any direction during the regular season. We didn't really know what we wanted to do ever. So it was kind of hard to fit in, like, where I wanted to be and like how I wanted to play the map with the team. Like so this year, I think it'll be easier to try to like to figure that out during the regular season. But during playoffs, we did a better job of orchestrating that and figuring it out compared to the regular season. So definitely gonna look for that consistency this year compared to last year. And I'm for sure gonna have a better year this year. I know it.
Yeah, Cyclone, how about you? Do you feel like this is a bounce back year for you, kind of like Aurora was just saying?
My role and Aurora's role are kind of different because he's more, you know, in the fight in early mid game, but I'm just kind of sitting there. So it's like, I felt like individually in my own lane, I was like okay-ish the entire year. Until World, I was like absolutely useless. But for this year, I guess you could consider it a bounce back year since I had to work on a lot of stuff in terms of team fighting and all that stuff.
So I think that your point about consistency is really interesting to me, Aurora, because, you know, like you said, you were a team last year that struggled in the regular season, was much better in the postseason. Paul, you're coming from a team that over the last 2 years was very inconsistent during the regular season, and then obviously incredible during the postseason, both you and Scary. So now it's kind of you're coming together as a group of guys who really struggled in the last regular season, but all played really, really well in the postseason. As a couple, you know, particularly to Aurora and Cyclone, but Paul, you're kind of a veteran now as well. How do you avoid those sorts of things? How do you become more consistent during the regular season?
What I don't know, man.
I feel like if you just have, you have
an identity.
Yeah, team identity is really big. Just having ideas as a team that everybody can get behind and just work towards getting better, like in terms of like how you play the map, how you draft certain things, like just everybody getting behind one thing and not having so many people pulling each other around everywhere else and just kind of creating some Frankenstein thing that doesn't work and then this is bad. But yeah, I think team identity is huge, like just trying to figure out what your team does well. And for team identity, like a lot of people always say that it's one thing, but someone's team identity could be big. Like a good example of it last year, I remember you bringing up on Cast a lot, was like Ghost's team identity was the early game identity, but they also had some strengths elsewhere that people didn't really talk about as much, and they just kind of tunnel visioned into it. So like you could have, you like a team identity is multi-layered thing. It's just not one thing that your team does well. So we got to figure out what's good for us, what we like to do, and how we're going to do it, and just keep improving on that and getting good at it. I don't know. That's it.
Oh, that's it. That's all we got to do. Nice and easy. I want to talk a little bit about expectations, because I think that not only as a group, but individual players have a lot of expectations on your roster this year. What are your expectations? Cyclone, I guess I can direct this one at you. What are your expectations for how your team is going to perform this year?
I think all our expectations just to win. I don't think there's actually that much to it. It's just win.
Just win. Just like Aurora said, that's all you got to do. Nice and easy. Paul, when I'm talking about individual expectations, I think you are the one that comes to mind for me, in that, you know, you've got a big spotlight shining on you now after the last 2 years and your performance at Worlds, particularly last year. Do you feel any heightened pressure coming into this year to try and match that expectation?
Well, firstly, I want to be able to actually win during the SPL season, because on SK and PK, we kind of just got like pounded during the regular season. What, 7th seed, 6th seed, something like that. So I kind of want to actually be a top team, and answer like the second part of your question. I think heightened expectations. I don't know. I don't really. Like, if I feed or like. I don't know if people remember when I blinked in versus you guys' Hebo level 1 yeah. and die.
To stop a bet.
Like, people are going to say I'm a bot or whatever, but I mean, I don't know, just following your instinct at the time and just like, okay, maybe like you'll troll sometimes, but I don't know, just believe in yourself, man. And yeah, I don't know. I'll play my best, and if I feed, I feed. If I win, I win. That's what's going
to
happen, I guess.
It's a good way to look at it.
Yep. A lot of people are saying, like, I'm hearing it from pro players and fans alike, that you're in contention now after these last 2 years for best mid player of all time in the conversation, for best player in SPL history someday. Do you buy into that at all? Do you feel like you've reached a different level of mid play?
I don't know. How do I answer this question? These questions are like traps, because it's like,
correct.
If you answer it wrong, it's like, this guy's ego, man.
Just like, who cares?
I don't know. Maybe if
your
I win,
not over. So
wait, what?
Your career's not over yet.
Yeah,
right?
It's not. Oh, yeah, that's exactly, dude. So if I win this season, 3x with Ronnie, maybe technically we are the best. We win. I mean, technically.
Yeah.
And yeah,
you'd be the first 3-timers with me.
First, dude. Xbox doesn't count, man.
Oh, man.
Okay,
you would have claimed
like,
it if you.
It's
won.
Like half a point or something.
You would have claimed it if you won that.
No, I wouldn't.
You would have.
No, I wouldn't.
I don't claim it.
Never mind. All right, let's go. Did I even answer the question, man? I don't even remember.
Kind of, sorta. You know, it was, you were in the direction of an answer, and then you veered away.
In conclusion,
yes.
Maybe. I don't know. If I play good, if we win Worlds, then technically. But if I lose, then I'm even with all the people who've won Worlds twice. So. We'll find out this season. Tune in.
There it is. There's our cut that. There's our promo for the SPL for Season 8. We're going to be using that one for sure. I one of the questions that I had about this team was what Cherio's role was going to be. I know it's kind of early in the season, but I'm just a Cherry stan. I think a lot of people are. Love the way that he played the game. Has he been involved so far? Is that going to be a little bit later on? What's his impact been like for the team?
Yeah, no, he's been involved. The few times we've scrimmed, I think we scrimmed probably like 4 to 5, 6 times, something like that. We scrimmed a handful of times already, and he's been there for every scrim, sets them up. If I ask him to look at something, he'll look at it and record whatever. He'll do whatever in terms of that kind of stuff. But I think the big thing is that he used to be a jungler recently, last year, and he was very good as well. and we're bringing in somebody who role swaps, so just having someone to ask questions to. And Cherry still plays the game too. Like, mm-hmm. you see him uploading all his YouTube videos. Check those out, by the way.
Yep.
And he still plays the game. He still knows what's going on. Scary can ask some questions. Just having someone who knows so much about jungle, having a lot of experience, is definitely a really good tool to have, especially for Scary, I feel like, because he's just coming into a new role. And I think he's helped him quite a bit already. So I think he'll keep helping him. And I think he'll keep helping us as a team. And I know that he has some cool ideas about draft, and he helped a lot with Space Station's team last year in terms of draft as well. So I think he's a great fit. And me and Cherry have always got along, so I'm happy to have him on the team.
One of the things that newer fans of the SPL might not remember or know about you, Aurora, is that I think you're one of the most creative players in the league. You've been willing to try a lot of different things, Cyclone as well. I mean, the Bologna and Vamana ADCs of the past and that kind of stuff. I also think of Cherry in that same sort of vein. You think you guys are going to be cooking up anything weird this season?
Yeah, why not?
I hope so. I miss that kind of stuff, man. That weird stuff, I think, is always more fun to watch. So you guys are living, I know we were talking about it earlier, but for the video, you guys are all living in a team house this year, right? Are all five players going to be there?
So four of us are living in a team house in like 15 minutes away, 20 minutes away from the studio, and then Benji's living alone.
In Atlanta?
He's like...
Downtown?
I don't think he's downtown. I forget where Benji lives exactly. I think he lives in like Buckhead or something, maybe like right outside of Buckhead. I don't remember where he lives exactly, but Buckhead's like right outside of the city, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. So he lives closer to the city, so I don't know where he lives exactly. And then Cherry is living back at home, so.
Right.
But yeah, that's our setup for this year.
I know you guys did apartments last year with Radiance, right, for Aurora and Cyclone. Paul, you were in a team house with PK. How different do you think that dynamic is, being in those separate apartments as teammates and being majority together at a team house?
Well, the apartments we had last year were actually really nice.
We were literally right
across. Because we had the two apartments that were just right across from each other.
Oh, okay, nice.
So it was like we're connected, kind of. So that was nice last year. And we all scrimmed in the same place as well and played our SPL games in the same place. So I feel like, in terms of like playing together and stuff, it was fine. But maybe like just from apartments in the past, we'll probably see each other a little bit more like in everyday situations. So maybe it'll be good. But yeah, that's my take on it, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, I haven't lived in the house long enough, so I don't know.
Paul, you've been with the same guys. You were saying that, you know, you and Ronnie have teamed together since you came into the SPL. Yeah. You were with that crew for a long time. Is it exciting, a little scary to step out and team with new people? How's your view on that?
Yeah, it is. I mean, because when I started playing in season 5, right, I only played with like pretty much the same people besides Sam, because Sam for Fred. It is going to be kind of weird at first, but I'm sure it's I'll settle in fine with Ronnie. But yeah, it is kind of weird.
I'd say that for whatever reason, you've gravitated towards supports with pretty big personalities. First it was Neil, now Aurora. Those two, they like to have some fun from time to time.
Yeah.
You've been getting along well with them so far, though?
Yeah. It's been pretty good so far, yeah.
No, it's been pretty bad.
No, I'm just kidding.
After the broadcast turns off, oh, man. yeah, no, I mean, I think scrims have been going pretty well. I don't know, man. I have a feeling it's going to be like, it's either going to be a catastrophic failure. We're going to go 0-10 in every lane, or we're just probably just going to like be pounding everyone. I don't know. I don't think, actually, maybe, no, I mean, I guess, I was thinking that I guess we could be mediocre and then just be beating like the bottom two teams or something, but. It's one of those three scenarios, all right? The profit.
That's correct, yeah. Look at it this way. It's a 50-50 every game. You either win or you lose. So you see,
yeah.
Yeah, we're in a good spot there if that's, if that's
50-50.
The case. Lastly, guys, I mean, with everything kind of coming back to normal shortly, you know, no more pandemic, hopefully, in the near future. What are some of the things that you guys are excited to go out and resume doing once the world has calmed down a little bit?
That's a you question, dude.
Why is that a me?
Well, I don't go outside. You can take your turn and then you say something. And
I don't go outside.
No, you guys
dude.
Should say something first.
I've got to think.
Okay, fine.
I'm thinking.
I don't do anything outside.
For me, I'll probably start working out again more. I got pretty lazy during this whole thing. Getting healthier in terms of that. And then just being able to go out and like I didn't really see any of the casters. Like I remember hanging out with you the first year I was here a lot more. That was fun. I didn't really talk to anybody or go out and hang out with anybody at all because I was trying to be safe. So
yeah,
that'll be fun. And then just maybe, like I was saying to you earlier, maybe get like a basketball pickup going every couple weeks with some of the SPL guys and whoever at High Res wants to do it. It'd be pretty fun.
Lots of Commander games in our future.
I'm down.
Yeah, that's what we're going to do. Cyclone, Aurora's, you know, by Paul's plan, it was Aurora, then you, then
your
him,
turn, so and then my turn.
Being able to go out and do stuff with other people. Like, we can't really go out and do anything. We can only, like, go visit each other. Mm-hmm. That's kind of it.
Yeah.
Like, going out and eat or, you know, going to, like, Six Flags or something.
Yeah. Shout out to the local Wood Fire Grill.
Yeah. That place is great.
Yeah. Going to be there a lot, I'm sure.
For Paul. Me... since I live in Canada.
But can you say that one more time?
Canada.
Thank you.
Yeah. That's all. Anyways, the lockdowns were like pretty strict down there. So after Worlds, I didn't even get to like hang out with any of my in real life friends or anything like that. So when it ends, look forward to that, you know, maybe do some skiing or something.
Yeah, that is well for me. I'm excited to see my friends. I haven't got to see them that much at all since this whole thing started.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, guys, I'm really looking forward to seeing you guys play this year. I think you're going to be one of the most fun teams to watch in the whole league, and I'm excited for it. So thanks for taking the time. Enjoy the rest of the offseason, however short it may be, and thank you for watching. We'll see you next time here on Team Check-In.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, that's skadoodle.